This was by far the hardest year in all of our careers. You know, learning to teach in this modality in a virtual world really created some ingenuity. I mean, teachers had to really think outside the box on how to interact with students. And we did see some veteran, you know, all-star fantastic teachers regretfully have to retire probably sooner than they intended. But at the same time, we know that they did what was right, what they needed for themselves and for their families. And we were glad that we were able to support them in any way that we could. But resilience is definitely the key word for this last school year. I think that parents have a new sense of respect for our educators because they have been in the classroom. They've had a very open window to seeing exactly what's happening in the teacher's classroom and how they interact with students during this time. But I also think that for teachers, it's been difficult because some of the concerns that we've had on our end is trying to figure out how to get children connected. Did they have the adequate support system at home? Did they have parents that could follow up with assignments and things that they were doing? But also the social emotional learning aspect of it. We saw so many children that were devastated because of personal loss. They lost grandparents, they lost family members. Some parents lost their jobs, and so the financial hardships of what the pandemic meant or how it impacted their lives was something that was truly traumatizing for the child and very worrisome for the teacher. The educators were trying to figure out how to get them resources, making sure that they came to school to get their free lunch and breakfast, and all those things are things that we're always worried about. We've thought about what it meant for children academically as well. This has turned into another educational gap, which is, we're calling it the COVID gap. You know, we usually just talked about the summer slide, but now this is something that's really impacted children worldwide. We know that there are certain things that will continue to be part of our classrooms. We need to continue to keep our social distancing, our spacing between our desks. The CDC recommends that certain things continue to be in place in the classrooms. And because it's become politicized, I'm really concerned over mask wearing as well. We don't know which children are vaccinated, the older ones, which ones are not, as well as teachers. And when you have a set of students that are wearing a mask and a set of students that are not, you know, will that cause any tension or friction even among students? Is there going to be bullying because some kids are wearing masks and some kids are not wearing masks? And all these things are aspects that we have to consider, we have to talk about, and we have to make sure that our students are safe. So we're going to continue to watch what the positivity rates are locally. And, you know, we hope and pray that people are getting vaccinated and that all those that are eligible continue to get vaccinated as well. I definitely think that the future of education is going to look and feel vastly different. I think that this crisis made us look at education differently and see that different children learn in different ways and that we can reach children in different ways as well. I just hope that every child and every one of my colleagues everywhere, you know, has a fantastic year. I mean, we miss seeing each other. We miss being in person. And, you know, I can't wait for our students to be back, of course, as long as everything is safe, as long as we can protect them and make sure that everyone is healthy within our school sites and our classrooms. But at the end of the day, we just want everybody to continue to learn, to be happy, to be healthy, because of course, if you're happy and you're healthy, then you can learn. And we want all of our children to be learning and be with us next year.